Morning. It's Ask Dr. Ben. Today is filling up with craziness. I'm gonna try and get a couple of these knocked out before I just get buried. First question is from Lee. Hello, Lee. I'm getting mixed messages about wearing masks. Specifically, I just read a mask is worthless regarding protection. If a person sneezed or coughed in the mask, a 0.05 micron particle will shoot through it like a grain of sand through a tennis racket. Let's see. Yep, that's true, but also not true. We're getting to it. Let's see. This person went on to say that the mask's actually like a vacuum. What the heck? Making it more dangerous because you suck in the particles deeper into your lungs. No, that's not true. That's insane. Can you please clarify the facts about the safety of everyday masks available to us to wear to the grocery store? Yeah, sure. Yeah, they're safe and they help. So, there's a new study out today which confirms what I've been saying and a lot of people have been thinking, but it's nice to have science to confirm this. Yeah, rather than just, reasonable guesswork and hypothesis. What they show is that a regular old mask, like a homemade cloth mask of some sort, will block somewhere between 50 and 100% of the particles that you would block with a surgical mask. And like an N95. And if you are able to make one of those little cloth masks or paper masks or whatever, and put an extra thing around it, like little like the top of a nylon stocking, for example, that just pins it down to your face and makes for better filtering. So what you're getting here are different things. So the pore size and the filter size is not good enough to prevent individual particles from going in or going out. But thank goodness that's not what happens. Yeah. So we think it takes probably somewhere in the vicinity of 10,000 to 100,000 individual viruses in a blob hitting you at the same time to actually start an infection. Anything less than that, and the odds are that you are not going to end up infected. And the only way you can get that much virus at one time is going to be in a respiratory droplet. And so this is something from coughing, but also, I mean, you've been too close to people when they talk. Sometimes, pleh, yeah, they'll do their P's and they'll spit a little bit out. I think I did that on the computer. Yeah. It happens. And so these are respiratory droplets. They are coming from the throat and lungs, and so they can contain very large amounts of the virus, and that's what a mask prevents. Masks block those almost completely. Individual little viruses, yeah, they can get through, coming in or going out, but the individual viruses are not what's going to get you. It's going to be the big blob of virus coming in from talking to your best friend about their, perfectly pickled, packed peppers, whatever. Yeah. Yeah, a peck of them, probably. That's the idea. So there you go. I would say definitely wear a mask. That seems to be what all the best advice is. And frankly, I look at people who are not wearing masks and I think, what do you have against humanity, you goofball? Yeah, that's just me and that's opinion, not science. Yeah, so there we go. Thanks very much. This was Ask Dr. Ben.